What's up, everybody? Let's get some more people in here real quick. I'm not going to make this long. I'm just going to make this very short because I see a lot of people on here crying about what happened in Notre Dame. It's sad. Sad. But y'all better know some real history. Okay? Know some real history. Hurry up and share this out. Need not be on here long. But I will show you some stuff. And no, I didn't learn this from a college. This is called basic common sense, where you have truly have knowledge of who you truly are. When you have knowledge of who you truly are. I'm drinking my shake right now, but we're going to try to hit this real quick. So hit the like button, y'all. Subscribe. Hit the like button, yo. Hit the like and subscribe. Peace. Hey, did you see the title, Jasmine? You see the title? So we're going to kick this thing off real quick. We're going to kick it off. All right, y'all ready? Y'all ready? Let's share it out. Let's get these likes. We got 8 people. Let's get the likes on here. He said, Salam, Muslim. I was going to say something crazy. What makes you think I'm a Muslim? Makes y'all think I'm a Muslim? Because of my name? Because of my necklace? Which one? Ooh. So let's get this thing started, y'all. Let's share this out real quick because I need not be on here long. But, you know, peace, 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 peace. Tweet this out. Share it out. Let's go. Let's go. Share it out. Hip hop. Let's go. Money.
M-O-N-E-Y. What you need, you just get by. Money, honey. Ain't it funny? Money. People want to die. It seems without money, people cry. People will lie. You cannot deny. Without money, you can't apply. For anything that catches your eye, I wonder why. The root of all evil. Let me teach you. Now, who am I? The MC. Teaching my people. Don't live that lie. You got to get money, but don't let money get you. Break it down like whatever you want. Whatever you spend your money on strong, yo, that's what you blow. Spend your money on these honeys, yo, if that's what you want. Spend your money on attorneys if you're going to court. If I look around your neck, I can see what you bought. What you think, you get respect? No, you taking the short. Yo, you need the money, of course, you need it to live.
Yo, what you put your money on,
Chris? Right on my kids. Let's rewind that back.
No, you taking the short.
Yo, listen, the money, let's go back.
You need it to live.
You put your money on,
Chris. Right on my kids. One more time.
M-O.
No, you taking the short. Yo, you need the money, of course. You need it to live.
Yo, what you put your money on, Chris?
Yo, right on my kids.
M-O-N-E-Y. Don't ask why. It is the root of all evil, though very necessary to your livelihood. It's all good when you've got enough. Till enough ain't enough. And you hit upon rough times. You make your money and I'll make mine. Mine, 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 mine.
Yeah, we need the
M-O-N-E-Y.
Don't get me wrong, mistaking this song. Like money is not important, yes it is, just be strong. It's the reason for the thieving and that war going on. It's the reason that you seeing all these girls in the thong. It's the reason that the radio's on. It's the reason that you believe in. You gotta work from sun up till dawn. It's the cravings that connect you to that money you making. Your desire is the fire, got you feeling you slaving.
Free yourself.
Money doesn't make you the man.
Be yourself. Be a more. So let's rewind it back.
Money, really, the fire that you feeling, you
be yourself.
Free yourself. Money doesn't make you the man.
Be yourself.
A man gets his money in grand. Okay, I'ma get this money really all day. But not to the point where I'm going the wrong way. I'ma put my money down on rides and all that. Hook up the house so me and my spouse can fall back. Invest in my knowledge.
Way beyond college.
Write books and fly hooks in my cottage. Cheese. Bling, bling, yo, please. Money is an energy that gets what I need. I can understand them cats that rap flossing and fronting. It's all good. They from the hood never had nothing. They just got their money and everything sunny. Hear what
playing boy and looking for bunnies.
Then we floss what we bought, forgetting that sharing is what we've been taught. Cause this here getting money is an individual sport. Money can get me in to the same places where years ago my bros and sisters with black skin were confined to the back door and the kitchen.
Last verse, where your cash purse?
Message.
To your wallet, nothing a lot of that hurts. Breath stinking, you're thinking, but can't afford certs. Need the dollar and baby hollering, nah, work. I don't know how you gonna get the dough. You could become educated.
You could become a hoe.
You could do both. That's like putting
bread on toast.
The bread is the knowledge. Butter is what gets you there, coach.
Money is funny how a piece of paper Listen. Can make or break your very existence. Quick as it come, quick as it go, you better know about the ebb and the flow. You get money in droves, trick it on cars and blow, throw dollars at black queens, cause for the dough they'll strip their clothes. And for the right amount of money, a king will pimp his queen into being a hoe on a stroll. Life will always be hard when you choose to make money your God.
Shout out to MC Light for that one, boy. That's truly real hip hop. Niggas will sell you out in a heartbeat. Yeah, you need money, but you gotta don't let money make you. You make the money, money don't make the man. So we go tricking on cars, tricking at strip clubs, tricking on porn, tricking on football, basketball, with nothing of substance. Damn. That's a hella song. Shit is out. Y'all could dislike it all y'all want. Just do the research on what I'm saying, baby. Just do the research on what Brother Sabir Bey said. I didn't even have this planned. I'm going to keep it 120 with y'all. I don't have nothing planned. It's just when it's in you, it's in you. Period. Okay? I appreciate you dropping this information on the Uninformed by a Good Brother. Give thanks, family. Share this out. Tweet it out. Because I want y'all to get this. How many people know that Notre Dame architect come from the Morrish architect? How many people know that the original Irish was us? How many people knew that? See, we're so caught up in slavery that we don't even recognize who we truly are. You have Negroes running around calling by themselves African Americans and black. African and black, or whatever we want to call ourselves today or tomorrow. But the architect come from your ancestors, the Moors. These people right here, let me help you out. Those people. See, the black folks that trying to keep you asleep know this. I bought this book when I was in Grenada, so I'm going to open up this book too. I'll open up this to let you see what they were calling us over there. I know it was. Hold on, let me help you out a little bit. Notre Dame right there, y'all. The cathedrals. Right? Moorish and French. Let me explain to y'all also that Morocco is a French word. Morocco. I'm not one of these Moors that's Moroccan. Morocco is French. The original people there was called the Amazigh. The Amazigh in Morocco. Amazigh. Which these people are. They are burning the history down in Brazil, France, and California. This is you. So let me help y'all out a little bit. In this book, I'm going to come out of this book real quick to show y'all that. Also, there's another architect. This is my calendar I put together, y'all. This is a calendar I put together. Now, when I was in Barcelona, I showed this guy, Gaudi. He got his influence from the Moors also because he was a Moor. Gaudi, look him up. Most black folks don't even know about Antonio. Excuse me. They don't even know about Antonio Gaudi. Ask any black person how many of y'all know of this man's architect. And ask where he get his influence from. I was there. When I go back, I'm going inside to take pictures on the inside. when I go back to Barcelona. We don't even know who he is. So all the architects still come from your ancestors, the Moors. But we want to reject who we truly are. But I'm going to show y'all how everybody studies you black folks, you so-called black people. Let's get these likes up, y'all. This ain't gossip. Let's keep it 100. How many of y'all really heard of this man right here? I was in an Uber in Vegas, and a European lady told me most people in the United States don't even know who this man is. And he's very well known. Very, very well known around the world for architect. But black folks don't know that part. They only know about the slave ship that they didn't find yet. The only thing they know about is the slave ship that they did not find yet. So, let's talk about it for a minute. Don't get scared, y'all. Don't get scared. And I'm on live, my Facebook live, every day. But I just want to bang this out real fast so y'all can understand. The Moorish and the Irish, because we are the original Irish. How many people ever heard of the movie The King of Scotland? How many of y'all ever saw or heard King of Scotland? And Forrest Whitaker is playing the King of Scotland. How many? Notre Dame is Irish, y'all. I don't know if y'all know that or not. That's Irish, too. But y'all crying, oh, my God, they broke down Notre Dame and fired. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. That's how black folks are. But you're not finding out who the true Irish people are, the Moors. You don't want to hear about the architect. You want to keep thinking you African-American or black. That's our people like that. You don't want to hear about this, though, do you? Hold up. Let me flip this around. Give me 1 second. This called the Alhambra in the Irish connection. I'll let you marinate on that for a second, y'all. Marinate on that for a minute. This is what we should be talking about right here. Everything they got it from you so-called blacks. Everything they got from you black folks. Y'all just been hitting your damn head. Damn, Europeans paying millions for another one. Really? But we don't have no real, these colleges are not black colleges, y'all. These HBCUs are not colleges. Europeans will build up their own. They will build it up. While black folks go to an African American museum and learn about slavery. So-called blacks will go to an African American museum to learn about slavery. Hold up. James Kavanaugh Murphy. Let's keep it 100. How many of y'all ever heard of this man? Let me show y'all who this man is. Visiting the Alhambra. I want y'all to see the history that they're not talking about. He's Irish. Spent years traveling through Andalusia. Hold on, let me let y'all see this. Do y'all see this? Where's the black scholars talking about this at? $500 million raised already. Man, I need to come up with a scam. Could y'all send me $500 million? Could y'all please hit, because I'm giving y'all black folks something. Could y'all send me a cash app for $1 billion? God damn. They will back it. If I had $1 billion, I'd give a bunch of these calendars out. I give a bunch of these out. You see that? Under the Lucia. Let me show y'all this real quick. Hold up. Rock with me for a second. This is not even... They'll say, well, what's the purpose of having this, Sabir? Tell me what's the purpose of them giving up $500 million up. To say, oh, I was the first black. My child was the first black to go there. So this is my calendar. Under the Lucia. Under the Lucia. Okay, that's the Alhambra. Wow, damn. If I ask for $500 million, Jasmine, they'll look at me like I'm crazy. I'm gonna keep him 100. Let Sabir Bey ask for $500 million. So look, that's the Alhambra with Noble Drolley, John Henry Clark, Martin Luther King, our scholars, our people, but Negroes don't want to put no money up because of jealousy and envy. Ivan Van Sertima, this will turn into a whole lesson book. They stole money. They stole our money. Yes, they did. Yeah. $30 billion franchise. Wow. I'm not even concerned. I'm not even mad at this European. I'm going to keep it 100. I'm mad at so-called black folks. I'm mad at people. I even tagged my brother DL Hughley this. And I hope y'all share this to my brother DL. And I might send it to him on his cell phone. I want y'all to see. We don't get $1 billion for putting this information out. Okay, hold up. Let me let y'all see this. Bear with me. Then I'm going to go into some more history. Bear with me. The Alcazar. Built before Notre Dame. That's the Alhambra. I mean, the Alcazar, which is in Seville, which was built before. Which was built before the Alhambra. It was built before this. I was in there. I have over 300 photos while I'm inside here. Okay? Hold up. Give this man a major platform. Listen, I could have had the major platform if I sold my ass out before. Let me tell y'all this for real. I could have had a major platform if I sold my ass out. I've been in this game for 18 years on radio. 21 years in what I'm doing. In 18 years on radio. Y'all be surprised what was brought up to me. This is the Alhambra. Look at that fountain. I gave history on my lecture tour about that fountain. Your ancestors built this. Those people right there. Those Moors. They built that. You said, we glad you stayed solid. Yeah, I'm not nobody's hoe. That's the key. I ain't nobody's hoe, G. And I know certain people watching this and know exactly what I'm talking about in the industry. They're in the industry. The Alcazar. Malcolm X. Solar return. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan solar return. I'm putting Nipsey Hussle in here. Bob Marley, KRS-One, Taz Tariq Bey. We got a whole history of other names coming in here, man. I want y'all to see, but you won't put money behind real stuff. Let me let y'all see this. Alcazar. Yes, I'm rewriting the history correctly. But you got to fight with your own people because they petrified. They don't want to put money behind the real. But I will call their bluff. I will call their bluff. And y'all should question every last one of these people and watch what they do. They will block you in a heartbeat. They will block you or call you a coon or agent. That's me walking in Grenada. Marcus Musaya Garvey. And I'm bringing these to Merlin on Tuesday, y'all. Next Tuesday, the 23rd. Check it out. That's called the Mosquita. The Mosquita is like 2 football fields in Cordoba. These are my photos. This is not Photoshop, people. This is not Photoshop. So I'm going to walk y'all through this. This is the Alhambra. Yeah, everybody should. If everybody wants to donate, imagine, I should say $50, huh? Because this is a collector's item. That's another, I'm going to explain something to y'all also. Elijah Muhammad, solar return. Baba Dick Gregory, solar return. I'm going to explain something to y'all, what somebody just said. This is in Seville, beautiful at nighttime. Give thanks, Brother Rob. Give thanks, family. Dr. Ben. He hit my super chat up. Give thanks, Ben, brother. So, if you want to, y'all can hit this Cash App for the calendar. This is for the calendar. The original Cash App is also Sabir Bay, but this is for the calendar. But what I want to say about this, y'all, about this calendar, this is a beautiful view. A European took this picture of me because she loved that I had a fez on, and she asked me, was I a sultan? They asked me, was I a sultan? Rules of Success by Will Smith. So, I like that idea, what you just said, because I didn't even think about that. Those that want to correct their name, you can put it inside of a calendar, or put it inside my newspaper that's getting ready to come back out. My Civil Alert newspaper is coming back out. So, if we all, like, they put billions of dollars in Notre Dame, put billions of dollars behind the real people that's putting information out. So, y'all say get a bigger platform. Again, if I sold my behind, I can get a bigger platform. But I'm not like that. This is when they come at, when cats be having stuff they hiding. So let's go back into this history. How many people knew the connection between Notre Dame and the Moorish architect? So let me show y'all something in this book. Bear with me. Let me show y'all some more history. Y'all ready? Since people want to play this game, like they don't know who we are, the so-called black elite. This newspaper was in 1938. Will Spain fall to the same Moorish tribes that conquered the Moorish tribe that conquered turn 7-Eleven? All of that stuff is yours. I told you the word Tallahassee. Allah's name is in Tallahassee. Allah's name is in Callahan's. Take the word Callahan, loosen up, and you'll see Allah inside Callahan's. You was have Tallahassee, Allah, in Tallahassee, Florida. Yes, everything is ours. But see, when we play the black game, that's to erase you out of history. So I used to argue with Europeans. And they say, you black folks think you invented everything. I said, I didn't say black. I said Moors. See the difference, y'all? I said Moors. All right? Does that make sense? So here you go. In 1938, we should be flooding on a TV show with this, baby. We should be lit. But they don't want to have this real conversation. Hold up. I want y'all to see what they said here. Let me see if I can fix this. The Moors original nomadic tribes of Berber and Hamitites in Northern Africa. They was dark skin. Hold up, dark skin, right? Sometimes almost black, but often displaying the olive hue complexion of certain of the Caucasian people. Give thanks, Brother Bess. See that? Hold up, we're not finished yet. We're not even gonna go to, we cheering about Notre Dame. Let's show you this in the Afro-American newspaper. I want y'all to get this. I'm going to tie it all together for y'all. Y'all looking for somebody with degrees to tell you this. Hold up. 1937, October 30th. Langston Hughes talks about Hughes finds Moors being used as pawns. Langston Hughes, that is. So if you hear anybody talking about Langston Hughes, ask them where they get the information from. Don't get upset. Where they get the information from. Right? This is at a total different newspaper. But Langston Hughes said, I know that Spain once belonged to the Moors. It's kind of messed up. You probably get this online. I don't know if y'all can see that. I knew that Spain once belonged to the Moors, a colored people. Let y'all see this. Colored people. But we like gossip. We love the gossip. But we ain't talking about what Langston Hughes said when he saw them. So all the architects come from your ancestors, the Moors. Blacks didn't build nothing. Let me turn this around. Blacks. these modern day blacks didn't build nothing. These African Americans didn't build nothing. And y'all can come on my Facebook Live tomorrow. This is why they laugh at you. This is why they laugh at you. Because you running right here, got hit in your head and knocked unconscious, running around calling yourself black. There is a term called blackamoor, no doubt. There's a term called blackamoor. Hurry up and tweet this out, because I'm almost done. I don't need to stay out here all night long. Nah. How many of y'all ever heard of this man? I'm going to show you. Listen to what I'm saying to y'all. How many of y'all heard of this man? How many? Come on, y'all. Y'all taking too long. See, we only study slavery. That's why this book says, hold up. That's why this book says, all we asked of the black man is to be a good nigga and the rest will follow. Let me quote this one more time. All we asked of the black man is to be a good nigga and the rest will follow. So let me show you what I mean by that. I didn't write this. It's in the book. Hold up. It's in the book. All they ask, matter of fact, all they ask of the black man is to be a good nigga. The rest will follow on its own. Do y'all see that? Do y'all see that? No substance that these cats on YouTube is giving y'all. This is what's happening, right? Just follow. But we know nothing. You should look that book up too. We'll get back into that 1 second. So I asked y'all, how many of y'all ever heard of Washington Irving? Come on, y'all. How many? This is my book I bought back from Spain. And I bought this book back from Spain. This one and this one. I have many of them. I think I'm going to give this to Brother Taj on Tuesday because I don't need it. I can buy another one when I go back. Here's Washington Irving right here. Let me let you see who Washington Irving is. Let me clean my screen so y'all can get who this man is. He's another person that went to Spain. They paid to go to Spain to study the Moors. Washington Irving, 1783 to 1859, was perhaps the first American writer to be known across the globe. So why black folks don't know who he is? He was a passionate traveler. Let me let y'all see that. Who had the unique ability to capture the soul of the places he visited with tremendous sensitivity. Do y'all see this? Why black children don't know about this man? You should, because they studied you. They all study you. That's why they know how to manipulate you black folks. Washington Irving. Across the globe. Antonio Gaudi. We don't even know. Thanks to you, I have two of this book. Give thanks. So, teach your children. So I'm going to show y'all this. I'm going to go right back. Everything is dealing with Notre Dame and the Moors. So, let me open up this book for a minute. Now, I showed y'all about the complexion of the people, right? Hold on, we're not done. Between two black Moorish horsemen, the Inquisitioners was the famous for the hatred of the Moors. That's you African American and you black folks. That's the hatred that they have against you. But you think you so smart. So smart. See, this is what happens. When you speak the truth, they think you are, they think, I have some cats be like, I don't know about putting you on my show, Sabir. I don't teach hate. Don't get on none of these networks and talk like you really with our people. Or you want to talk intelligently to our people. Well, you ain't telling the truth about nothing. But you're a cheerlead. You're a cheerlead. all the gossip. I'm not done yet. Bear with me. Bear with me, y'all. Is everybody okay? Is everybody okay? I got to do it this way. I want y'all to see this song. Stevie Wonder talks about it. Hold up.
In 1492, you came up on the shores. 700 years, educated by the Moors. In 1492, you came up on the shores. 700 years, educated by the Moors. In 1492, you came up on the shores. 700 years, educated by the Moors. In 1492, you came up on the shores. 700 years, educated by the Moors. 17.
And he said, from 1492, when you came upon these shores, 700 years educated by the Moors. From now until then, we have been unrepresented people. And for the record, I know Stevie Wonder very well. We had this conversation. I just talked to Stevie 2 days ago. We always have this conversation. We have it. But he told me that I have a gift. My brother Stevie Wonder told me this. I have a gift. He said that he know that we're Moors. The rest of our people don't. If you don't believe that I know Stevie Wonder, if you got his number, if you see him in passing, just mention Sabir Bey and watch what he tell you. Watch what Stevie tell you. Just mention it. So, I don't have to make anything up. Let's go into a little bit more history. Y'all okay? Are we good? Let's go into the history. What am I looking for? Let's go into this book for a second. That I bought in Spain about the Alhambra. Think of the Moorish chief, one of the most famous paintings. This is a famous painting in Philadelphia Art Museum, which I'm going to take my brother Carlos inside there when I get back to Philly next week. The brother has a fez on his head right here. That's a fez. It ain't got nothing to do with no religion. Peace, Dan. Dan, give thanks. There it is right there. That's a fez. Look just like this man, though, right? Look like this man. But we want to argue and have these silly behind arguments and cheerlead everything else because we're getting finances from somebody, somewhere, somehow. But the real people, you don't want to have this conversation with. So I'm going to explain. I'm going to say this again. Law and history goes hand in hand. Law and history goes hand in hand. So, in this book, I'm gonna let y'all see. Moro, the seat of the Moor. The seat of the Moor. Plain and simple, not complicated. 1314, 1325. But let me show y'all something else. Bear with me. See the Europeans are slick on how they switch stuff up. If you come out of one book, you will probably believe what they tell you. Bear with me. Give me 1 second. Am I doing good so far, y'all? Am I doing good so far? Could y'all share this out? Notre Dame, I told you. I grew up in Philadelphia, in the Irish, not too far from the Irish. So, this is a Gaelic dictionary that I have. That's mine. Gaelic. Right there. Okay. Let's move over. Gaelic. Let me give you, show you. M-U-R-A-C-H. M-U-R-A-C-H. Gaelic. English. Moor. Did it say religion or ethnicity? Ethnicity. Let me let y'all see that so y'all won't think I'm making this up. The problem is we study one thing. We so smart that we so dumb. is us. We are the original ones. We are the original ones. Y'all not trying to hear me, though. But if it's dealing with slavery, we'll fall in line like a mother freaker. I'm not even done yet. Am I making sense, y'all? Am I making sense? This is like, this is elementary, G. So Moore's is out of this. It's an ethnicity. Exactly. You want to see it? You want to see more? Let me show you my picture with Washington Irving, too. That's in Spain. You see his name? They got a plaque right outside the Alhambra. Right outside the Alhambra. This is me in Granada. Washington Irving. This guy. Him. Right there. And I gave a lecture standing in front of there. The couple thought I lived in Spain. They thought I lived there. But hold on, let me help you out a little bit. Let me help you out. See, to throw you off, they have to tell you that the Moors were Muslims. Just Muslims. Moors or Mori. Dark race. Did it say dark religion or dark race? This is out of a book called Land and People, I believe it was. Land and People. Dark race living in the northern part of Africa. Right? See that? Africa, races of Africa are prehistoric and modern. Their name is derived from the ancient Mauritania. Mauritania, see? The 5th century to the 8th century. The Arabs, not the pale-faced ones that y'all keep talking about. The Arabs who conquered Spain were Moors. How much more do I have to show y'all? How much more? How much more proof do y'all need? Share this to these professors in college and ask them why Sabir never been there giving a lecture. The Gulf of Guinea. Right? The Negro slave replaced the Moorish slave. We're going to make sure you get your plaque and statue when the time comes as well. Give thanks. Here you go right here. Same people. I don't need no statue. I give thanks, but I don't need no statue. What's that rap song said? I don't need a statue to tell you how nice I am. I don't know. I got to find out who it is, but I can tell you this. It all come from the Moors. Hold up. This is an Irish book. This book was written in 1884 by David McRitchie. So let's talk about who the original Brits are. Look at this. The African Romans who built Britain. Oh, yeah. Hold up. We're going to get into that. Y'all ready? We're going to get into that. We're going to get into it. The African Romans who built Britain. That was in 2010. What African from Nigeria told y'all this? This came out in 2010, Black History Month. Let's move this to the side for a second. Let's open up this book before the Mayflower. Hold up. The first blacks were called Blackamoor, Moors, Negroes, Niggers, or Niggars. The word Negro is Spanish and Portuguese. The term black did not come into its general use until Virginia. Do you see that part, y'all? Do y'all see that? I want y'all to sit back. So I could call you a nigga in English and get away with it, black man. I can call you a nigga. Is this making any kind of sense? But you want to listen to these educated black fools, right? Or a lot of these educated blacks are petrified of this because they Christianize. I have a book called Portuguese in West Africa, but we're going to show that. We're going to show you that too. Hold up. We're going to show that also. Bear with me, y'all. Let's get into history. Slavery in the New World. Hold up. Here it is right here. the 15th century, when the Portuguese adopted similar practices in the trading with the West African Negro slave, displaced the Moors. Remember what I told you in this book right here? The hatred for the Moors. The hatred, because they know us better than we know ourselves. But you cheerlead them because you think they're smart. They're not smart. They duplicate everything. Look, same people. Same. I want y'all to get it, snapshot it. What's West African coming to tell you that? What West African coming to tell you that? We're going to go into some ancient and modern bricks now. Bear with me, because I'm going to come from this book too. We're going to come out of here too. So let's go back over here. Let's open up this book and see what they was talking about. What these people were called African Americans. Moorish blood. Peace. My sister. Hold up. Give me 1 second. This book was written in 1884. But y'all crying. Talk about the Moors accepting and refused to accept the laws of the new civilization. Hold up. 1 second. Damn, it's crazy when you know your books, man. This is at the end of this book, so bear with me. I'm going to show you what they talks about us. While y'all listen to all these wannabe black scholars. This one talks about with the dark skin of as dark as the Ethiopians and Moors. It's all up in here, y'all. Same people. We're not separate. Bear with me, y'all. y'all don't want the truth. Well, I hope y'all share this out, tweet it out. Bear with me. Here it is. In 1681, the Indians of New England, or Moors, so we were both, as they were also styled by the settlers, that's the Europeans, William Penn, from where I'm from, Philadelphia, was by William Penn to be what? Black as gypsies. They talk about you Moors. But we smart though, right? We so smart. You crying about Notre Dame? When they taking your history right in front of your face and you don't even challenge these black scholars or these black leaders? Really? I told you before, all they asked of the black man is to be a good nigga, and the rest will follow them. All they asked of the black man is to be a good nigga, and the rest will follow. So let's go down a little further. New Century Magazine of 1883. British gypsies. So the gypsies was us. So the original gypsies, right? Hold on, let's go back. Look at this. Signify that of the what? Gypsies of 1681 were definitely blackamoors. Now, didn't I just read that from another book? Blackamoor was in there. Blackamoor is right here. Really? Hold up. Y'all not convinced yet? You ever see the movie Gladiator when it said, "Are you entertained?" Are y'all convinced yet? Y'all not convinced? Are y'all convinced yet? Get back to the plantation before you get caught. I ain't on nobody's plantation, G. You talking to the wrong person. You must be that same troll. I'm not on nobody's plantation, G. Free people get told. So let me show you this. Oh, you. Because it looked like you just said, me. You ain't going to get fired. Listen to me. Let me explain something to you. Lose your job and find your work. Because the way you got it says, get back to the plantation. You didn't say, I get back. You said, get back to the plantation. But lose your job and find your work. I haven't heard any of our people really inquire about the charters. What's that? Charters, which is original Notre Dame. Listen, hold up. I'm going to help them out, Jaquetta. I don't need to be on here long, but look. White people blacken their faces not only to do what? For the Morrish dance, but it was the attraction for black skin by David McRitchie. Where's my David McRitchie? Let's look at David McRitchie one more time. So it's not about the complexion of your skin. It's what's in your head. It's what's in your head. So let's go back. They darkened their skin to imitate the Moors. British people, a fair complexion. British, we're going to go right over to this. Duke and Norfolk, you see that? That's Moorish architect. Moorish architect. All of it. Y'all not trying to hear me, though. Hold up. Here it is. A fair complexion was a custom of blackening their faces artificially. In 2019, we have tanning booths. 2019, we have tanning booths artificially that they might better pass for what? So, hold up. Let me. Can y'all get me an educated person real quick? Could y'all please get me an educated person? So in order for them artificially so they can look like Moors. You mean to tell me like that person? Like him? Really? You can research everything that I'm showing y'all. Everything. In January 12, 1605, Queen Anne of England and her ladies blackened their faces and arms to the elbow. Hold up. So the Morisca, let's talk about this for a minute. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about the Moorish dance for a minute. Let's talk about that. Let's open up this book. But y'all pay millions of dollars for lies. Here it is. Moorish dance. Folk dance performed throughout England. I told you, they study y'all people. They study black folks. Moorish dance is the English version of the European Morisca of Moorish dance associated with the Moors. Really? Blackening their faces to conceal their identity? Woo, they want to imitate you so bad. Y'all keep thinking it's about your complexion of your skin. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Nah. They know you better than you know yourself. You say you need not say no more, my good Moor. I know, I'm great, stop. But I want y'all to share this out. I need them to share this out. I need not see no more, baby. But I need them to stop playing, G. Because they playing with black folks, man. They are playing with the black, so-called black folks. We love to play victims. We love playing victim. We love it. Go look this book up and tell me how much that one costs. Hannibal was a Carthaginian. Hannibal was a Carthaginian Moor. Go look it up. They have a military song that says, from the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli. From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli. I'm almost done. I'm almost. Challenge some of these black scholars. They'll talk crazy with y'all. Talking about you telling the truth. I'ma tell the truth. I'm gonna speak truth to power. You ain't speaking nothing. How could you falter when you the rock of Gibraltar? Last time I checked, it was $800, right? That was 800, right? Thank you. It's a lot of jewels in that book right there. How could you falter when you the rock of Gibraltar? I had to get off the boat to walk on water. Remember Jay said that? How could you falter when you're the rock of Gibraltar? I had to get off the boat to walk on water. Y'all not trying to hear me though. It's not slave talk. We have to have common sense, y'all. Common sense. Yes, more is forever, baby. Black and colored. Black and colored like white are, on the other hand, European words, not the white man words. European words, not white man. Ethiopian and Moor were properly used to describe the so-called blacks until the 1500s. As these black scholars, these black professors, and don't let them off the hook. What were you called before the 1500s? Don't let them off the hook. Ask them. Ask them. Or tell them to holler at your brother Sabir Bey. They can talk all the smack they want. I'ma tell you, in a battle with this, they're gonna lose. Hands down. I'm nobody. Then again, I am somebody. Let me correct that. I am somebody. But they will lose. Yeah, they stuck in that Christianity. Shout out to my brother Malik, man. What's up, Leek? Shout out to Malik. The Marine Corps official hymn. Yes. Hannibal was a Carthaginian Moor. Carthaginian Moor. Do the research, man. Carthaginian. Just look it up. The Maurines. We were always the navigators, but if you can... if you can write somebody out of history... You are right. As people who Masons maroon another. Drop those gems, King. Thank you so much. Give thanks. I want y'all to tweet this out and share this out. Hit me up. Requestinfo@thesabirbayshow.com. Again, requestinfo@thesabirbayshow.com. I will be joining my brother Taj and my brother Abdullah Bay on the 23rd of next week in Maryland, baby. In Maryland. Booking. Thank you, my sister Jaquetta. The booking is there for me too. Requestinfo@thesabirbayshow.com. If y'all want the calendar, holler at me. I'm making some more with my brother Nipsey, Todd's birthday, Karis one birthday, Bob Marley's birthday. We got everybody inside here, man. Be productive. Whatever you do. I'm bringing these to Maryland next week. Right there, 23rd. The one who controls the printed page controls the thinking. They don't, not even if they created that, they don't control nothing, people. It's a mental thing. Listen to me. It's a mental thing. Let me quote KRS-One. Your paycheck dictates the amount of truth that you're willing to tell. Your paycheck dictates the amount of truth you are willing to tell. So I gotta go, y'all. Appreciate everybody. Check out my Facebook, Sabir Bay's Facebook, IG, Real Sabir Bay. See you on Tuesday. Requestinfo@thesabirbayshow.com. Yes.
Nine albums, many tempos. What's your name again? White freestyles, many demos. We don't match, you make me laugh immensely. Like when Michael Jackson married Priscilla Presley. I'm not the one you wanna battle at all. You'll be quickly forgotten like them cabbage patch dolls. Yes, yes, y'all, it's the Blastmaster. When I finish rocking, you can't go on after. To every MC, I'm each, giving divine speech. I don't really battle, I teach. I'm infinite.
dead, you're ignorant. I'm omnipotent. Why you on the stoop just kicking it? Still, you can't escape my verbal rape. I got your demo, it was whack, I erased the tape. Take your ass back to wherever you came. Knowledge reigns supreme, it's all the same. Don't let me have to go back and rewrite the bridge is over. You a liar, you lied, you have no meaning. If you was rhyming on five, I switch over to Keenan. Or vice versa, I stay beaming, you stay dreaming for a rap. But you better watch your step. Anywhere in the world, I'll rule ya. In any club, I'll school ya. Don't let this white commercial fool ya. They're really running through ya and making contact. Use a gimmick, a match of lyrics, I'm that. I'm fine that, with your crime rap, I may be feeling you. But half that shit you pop, stop, you can't really do. Me on the other hand, brother man,
we'll cut you down, zigzag, zigzag. Listen, floor mat from the doormat. If you call my number, I bet you won't call back. Ooh, listen. One more time. Trying to battle the teacher?
The warning shot now is clearer. The only MC seeing me
is in the mirror.
Building, destroying you, refilling and toying you, taking out two of you, three of you, four of you, five of you, just as live as you, exposing all the lies in you. What you trying to do?
Biatch.
You're sweating nonstop, crew jetting up the block. You call them, crew come back, but they won't stop. It's getting critical. Chances of escape are minimal. I'm having you for breakfast, lunch, lunches in the two. Getting into you like a bacteria. What do you think? I'm one of these kids you be battling at your high school cafeteria? Yo, fuck it. Knowledge reigns supreme over nearly everyone. I leave that ass stunned. You still guessing?
Well, come on my Facebook Live tomorrow. Come on in live tomorrow, baby. Sabir Bay. Let me spell it for you. Right there. Come on in live. I dare you. I'll dare ya. Any given day, tomorrow, I'll turn on the guest request just for you. Just for you. Matter of fact, inbox me on Facebook and let me know when you live. I dare you. Sabir Bay. Let me give you everything. Who cares? Facebook, Instagram, pick your poison. It don't matter, G. Email me. requestinfo@thesabirbayshow.com. I'll be in Maryland. I don't even know where you at, but we'll be in Maryland on the 23rd. I'll be in Philly too. So wherever you want to meet, make it happen. All right?